Oh, sorry, hi. I've got to talk to you today about the internet. My name's John Phillips, and I'm from Into Music. I'm also too, as you can see, a guitarist and artist, a muso, and I've got my own band called The Urban Principle. But today I'm going to talk to you about the internet and how it will all affect us in the future. So I guess I need my notes. Thank you. Okay, today I'm going to talk to you about perceptions of the future and how they are going to affect you as an artist. I'll be provocative and hopefully it'll make you think. Essentially, we're going to look at three things. Economic structural change in terms of the big picture, not just the music industry, but the global economy, how that is changing, and you can draw certain conclusions from that and apply it to the music industry. And then secondly, we're going to look at the ever fast pace of technological change, which a lot of musicians are obviously at the cutting edge with because they particularly use computers. And thirdly and lastly, we're going to look at the relationship of the artist and bands and musos in relationship to the industry in general. Economic structural change. The first key point we have to look at under that is the new economy at the cutting edge, which is now being revolutionised. It's going through a paradigm shift. There is now less emphasis on the industrial manufacturing smokestack economy. It is now going through what we call a post-industrial phase and further accelerating faster in this paradigm shift into what we call the information, smart, high-tech, service, communications, multi-skilled, niche market economy. The other issue we have to look at in the new economy at the cutting edge is a power shift. This power shift is in terms of knowledge and information, which are now more powerful than money or violence in terms of wealth creation. The best information, the best ideas, the best thinking is going to win the day. Let's look at the costs on newer, smaller, powerful technologies. They're increasingly dropping. That means that there are more users, therefore there are more providers of services, and therefore that will then translate into more competition to provide better service to the consumer. We are in the age of creativity. There will be fierce competition over ideas and intellectual property and ownership. For instance, just look at the reason why the present government is changing the copyright laws. It's changing those laws in anticipation of the sorts of technological changes that are going to force structural economic changes. In the future, there's the increasing need for research and development time that has to be built in to any development of a new service or a new product. For instance, you just look at any of the Japanese companies or high-tech smart companies in America or Europe that increasingly use research and development time as a very big component in their everyday business. Another important trend that you're seeing now, and what we're going to see increasingly further in the future, is the rise of niche markets. It's been estimated by major economists that by the year 2000, between 60 to 75% of the market is going to be dominated by smaller independents. They will dominate the marketplace in comparison with the majors whose stranglehold will increasingly slip. You'll see the rise of small, for instance, boutique labels like fashion houses or small recording labels who succeed by responding very quickly to the mood and temperature shift of the fast changing marketplace. This will lead us into one very big factor that has been happening increasingly in the US economy and most Western economies in the 90s is the concept in terms of structural change of downsizing. For instance, you'll see large monolithic corporate dinosaurs are going to be increasingly in danger of a small, fast-moving, smart-thinking, fast-evolving, research-orientated, easily adaptable companies that respond and turn quickly to market change and shift, and therefore servicing the changing needs of their customers. The second heading we're going to look at is new technologies. The first point we've got to look at is how costs are dropping, and so therefore, because of accessibility for everybody, large one company or one monopolies controlling these powerful technologies are going. Accessibility to low-cost, powerful, high-tech tools for individuals and smaller groups and multi-skilling is rising, so therefore that means breakaways and split-offs from major companies and further downsizing and restructuring of industry and power. Because you have multi-skilling, specialisation is being challenged. I mean, why employ 30 people when you only have to employ 5 people who can all do the same job and do it cheaper? That has a lot of ramifications for the music industry. Accelerating speed of technological change and development and power transfer puts increasing pressure on industry to accelerate and keep pace with change of the marketplace. A split-second wrong decision for a company or an individual can mean catastrophic results for their business affairs, because we are dealing with ever-decreasing amounts of time to either make a right or a wrong decision. With the new technology, we are entering an age of multimedia. We're seeing a convergence at a lightning speed pace of all communications media of the like that we've never ever seen before, which is going to mean high speed transfer of data and information. That has a lot of ramifications. Those industries and businesses that are tooled up with this sort of communications equipment are going to be able to shuttle information backwards and forwards amongst themselves and make the right decisions before their competitor can. All this sort of low-cost, powerful technology is available to an individual. The new technologies are going to mean communications, convergence and merging, which we've mentioned before. Now, for instance, a lot of related or unrelated industries may come together as a result of this and form a new hybrid. We can take, for example, the computer industry and the music industry. As these two forms come together and merge in some areas, a new hybrid will be born. Now, it's reasonable to assume that once that hybrid is born, it is going to take off and accelerate at a much faster pace than its previous industries, and the result? Probably, most likely, some very serious heavy damage control to the two previous industries. And the reason why that would be is because outmoded, redundant forms of thinking, attitudes and procedures now have to shed and fall away.